back live on the Spoke of Milwaukee Show, St. James Edition Road Show. Road to the show continues. Shout out to Frankie Catwell, Baseball Classic. And that's how we're doing it. We're talking NBA. Rangers topped the Islanders last night. Really throwing cheese 97 miles an hour in early March. It's unbelievable. My butt is wet. We're here on the corner of Lake Avenue and Woodlawn, St. James, New York, Capital One Bank, and that's how we're doing it. It's a blizzard, so we're working. Shout out to all the workers that didn't call in today and are working in the blizzard. You're unbelievable. And that's how we're doing it. We're coming right back. It's the Spoke of Milwaukee Road Show, St. James, Long Island. Don't move. About that, it's the Spoke of Milwaukee Show, Road Show Edition, St. James. Don't move. We're coming right back.
Sparky Malarkey Karaoke, live in your living room. Let's go. Uh-huh. That's right. We back on Long Island, boy. Let's do it right. Get your scotch. Get your whiskey. Let's go. It's 9 o'clock on a Saturday. Regular crowd shuffles in. There's an old man sitting next to me, making love to his jolly and gin. Let's go. Turn this party out. Friday night edition, WBC, go Italy, go USA. Here we go. Bring it home, baby.
Now John at the bar is a friend of mine. He gets me my drinks for free. And he's quick with a joke, or a light up your smoke. But there's some place that he'd rather be. Just out of this place. Oh, la di da, la di da, la di da, la di da, la di da. Now Paul is a real estate novelist who never had time for a wife, and he's talking with David, who's still in the Navy, and probably will be for life.
Sparky's skills is number one. Shout out to Prospect Sport, number one. Holla back.
Rangers is practicing politics as a businessman slowly gets down. It's a shared drink they call loneliness, but it's better than drinking alone.
Thank you.
Let's go. Woo. Yeah.
Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight. We're all in the mood for a melody. And you got us feeling alright.
Mr. Ciafroni.
That is me. How are you doing, sir?
I'm always doing good every single day. You're live on the Sparky Malarkey Show. Oh, hold on. Let me turn on some lights. You're live on the Sparky Malarkey Show. What was I going to say to you? What are you doing, homie?
I'm going to pick up my daughter.
Oh, you're on your way. Is your wife with you?
No.
Oh, you're by yourself.
Correct.
So what are you going to do later? Just hang out with the family?
We got some plans later. Go over to some friends' house, hang out, have dinner.
Wind down from the work week.
Correct, sir. You should know what that's like. You work hard with the Malarkey Show.
Dude, you know what's really funny, bro, is... I swear to God, bro, I am fighting with like 20 people right now. Everybody's got something to say. Not really fighting because they all love me and I love them and we're blessed. But it's like, I'm exhausted, PD. I'm right in the camera here. I got the headphones on, the mic going. I did a St. James edition like I told you. I got a beautiful patio pie. And the thing is it's like, I'm trying to make this movement so all you assholes can be what you want, so you can come on the show in Manhattan, L.A., hang out, and we can live like stars, you know what I'm saying?
So what ultimately is the goal, Mr. Malarkey? Can I speak or no?
Yes.
Is it to basically take the Malarkey Show globally as a phenomenon in the radio talk show industry?
Exactly, and like you had said about the Dream Team, it's all from Smithtown. The whole Nucleus movement has come out of St. James, Nesconset, Smithtown area, and we're big. I mean, I'm watching Jim Messier and Frank Catalanato on the World Baseball Classic, and I'm like, Spork and Milwaukee's getting big. This kid the other day at Prospect Sport tells me.
Where do you see Jim Mencia on the show?
No. Who the hell? Last night, he said he went to your high school. Who's he talking to?
You spoke to Mencia last night?
No. Pete Ciafrone. I am. Last night, I'm watching the World Baseball Classic, right? Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'm watching the World Baseball Classic, and the guy, they all of a sudden, they show Frankie, the team Italy's like kind of looking down and out in the dugout. And to be honest with you, the shadows had crept over in between home plate and the pitcher's mound, so it was like Italy was done.
Yeah.
Because Mexico has such a good bullpen, so everyone's down, and there's Frankie standing next to the manager on the top step, you know, on one knee, and the other guy, Piazza, and he goes, and the commentator goes, oh, what a managerial staff you got there. That's a lot of major league experience. So then he goes, oh, there's Frankie Catalanato. And then one guy pronounces Big Cat's name wrong. He says Catalanato. Okay, he pronounces it wrong. The guy corrects him, and he's like, oh, man, that guy's a stud, you know, like, don't shortchange him kind of thing. And then all of a sudden, I was laying in bed, bro. I was, like, tired. You know, I don't work at all. I was really tired. So anyway, yeah, so listen, so, you know, and the game was, like, dragging in the middle innings. The game was sick at the end. So long story short, you're live. So he goes, yeah, Frankie Catalanato, 13-year vet. They show the name, the years. I come in the other room to record it, to put it on the show, and the fucking box froze up. I couldn't get nothing. Anyway, so, okay. So now I go back in the bedroom, and the guy's like, oh, he went to your high school. And he goes, yeah, he's a couple years younger than me. Great guy, good player. Who? Now, hold on. Real quick, before this game started, Jeff Nelson was commentating and he was like swallowing and turning red. He was like nervous or something. It was Jeff Nelson, I'm almost positive, man.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, so then what did he come in the booth? They Messier's out there? Tell me the truth.
I don't know. I mean, I thought Messier was kind of a quiet guy. I didn't know he did commentating, to be honest.
Listen, you want me to be really honest with you, man? Being the sports guru I am, I've seen Jim Messier in the booth before because he has a good face and a good head for it. And he's also to be confused with that guy Joe Lograno or something on Major League Baseball. He looks like him.
You know what I was thinking, Mr. Milwaukee, is I was just reading an article on USA Today about the first take. Would you cut me off?
No, the camera shut off, man. That's what I'm saying. Is I'm having a great interview with you, and
it's a low-budget show. It's a low-budget show. You got a camera from CVS.
It's an HD camera. It was $200 on sale. The thing's sweet. It's called the Canon Elf.
You got a freaking camera from Rite Aid. That that runs on AA batteries that lasts about 4 seconds.
No, bro. All I know is, listen, my cat peed in my favorite hat today.
Yeah, let me ask you a question. Did they win again?
And then I put on the World Baseball Classic all excited on Major League Baseball channel, it says the game's blacked out in the area. I don't even understand what they're talking about. But I didn't have the strike. I didn't have the strike to call DirecTV and fight.
You haven't paid your bills.
I paid it today.
You haven't paid your cable bill. That's why it's blacked out. And you haven't paid your LIPA bill either.
No, everything's paid, dude.
We got to get on that, man. We want to take this show international. We got to make sure bills are paid. You know, like you say in the show, I got to go pay
bro,
some bills.
Let me tell you something. When the person that I pitched this show to in a couple of months out in L.A. sees what I've done with negative dollars, $0, a camera, a pair of head, they're gonna have producers and writers, people to tell me what to do, and from then on out, I'm gonna have fun.
You think they're going to find me out? They're going to say, I love this kid?
Well, whoever are the best clowns, characters, and guests and callers are going to still always be callers for the next 10 years on the Sparky Malarkey Show.
Yeah, I mean...
The Sparky Malarkey Sports Talk Television Show.
Yeah.
Hey, shout out to Paulie Seafron. Where's he?
Paulie, I think, is at the gym right now.
Paulie's at the gym lifting weights, and your other brother's arrested someone in Brentwood.
Yep.
And your poor mother's at church praying for all of you.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like that.
So what else do we have to talk about? Is this thing still on? Oh, yeah, that's what I'm saying. So I got to check the camera. Then after I do then I got to go edit it myself.
Yeah. You're getting good at editing, though.
You know, everybody, you know, a lot of feedback, they say, I'm getting good at it, getting better.
Yeah?
Yeah, did you get Dr. Arnold's phone number?
No, you didn't give it to me yet.
I texted it to you. It's there now.
Oh, okay, that's what I thought. I didn't know if you wanted me to...